All right, guys, let's talk about probiotic side effects. Now, I get a lot of people coming to me who they have gut issues, so they start supplementing with probiotics and then they get problems with it. So I'm going to talk about some of the most common side effects that I see. And I'm also at the end of the video going to explain that gut health is a much bigger thing than just the bacteria in your gut, why you may be having those problems and what you can do instead and how you can think about those sort of things. So first of all, by far the biggest complaint I get, people get bloating and gas when they take probiotics. This can kind of be interlocked, interchanged with the stomach pain that comes along with the bloating and gas. People will often complain of headaches. And what's going on here, we believe, is that when you have, for example, fermented foods or anything with a protein source that's fermented, and this can include some of the probiotic products, is it can produce amines, and these amines can lead to, we believe, these headaches. Okay, now the weird thing is you can also see constipation and diarrhea, and you kind of don't know which one you're going to see. So it can kind of be a bit of a guessing game there. Some people will take probiotics, complain of sluggishness. They just don't have the energy. Another thing we can see, people will take probiotics and get redness and swelling. We believe that this can be almost a histamine type reaction. Some studies show, and again, I'll put links to the studies in the description. Some studies show, hey, if people take probiotics, they should go on a low histamine diet. Other studies don't support that. There is no change. And then finally, infection risk, particularly in people with compromised immune systems. It's very easy to throw a probiotic at somebody who's got immune system issues, and then they can really have problems. So that's something that we generally want to avoid. So the question is, why are these side effects happening? What's going on? Well, as I mentioned earlier, you have to think larger than just going, okay, I'm having gut problems, so that means bad bacteria. I need to feed it with good bacteria. First of all, a lot of probiotic products on the market aren't all that good. They don't contain as wide array of beneficial bacteria that they claim, but really, in a lot of cases, they're not even meeting or addressing the root cause of the problem. And what is the root cause? Well, if you have gut problems, what can happen is that anything you take in orally or by mouth can actually be turned into a toxin. Okay, and what I mean by that, the bacteria in your gut, you can get to a point where it can even take very beneficial things like B vitamins and carbohydrates and actually convert those to harmful substances. So I'll get people who go on low carb diets and they're like, oh, my gut problems are so much better. And they are initially, and then they come back full force because we're not addressing that root cause. And some of those, your gut health is tied to so much more than bacteria. Your diet plays a huge role in that. Your sleep plays a huge role in that. Are you taking any drugs, herbals, other natural supplements? That can play a role. The other thing that can play a role, and I don't want to get too deep in the weeds here, but think about it this way. Your gut lining is really, people misunderstand, you have to have enough energy in your body to support all of the functions in your body. That includes your gut. So a lot of people aren't eating in the right way, providing the necessary nutrients for these processes to take place. And then we start seeing a decrease in short-chain fatty acid production, and then that ball starts rolling downhill, and then we have more problems. So many of these factors have nothing to do with, you needing more beneficial bacteria. So we give people probiotics, and they can cause these problems because your gut microbiome, your diet, your sleep, your short-chain fatty acid production is all messed up. So probiotics, in some cases, can provide a short-term benefit, but in a lot of cases, they just end up causing problems again because we're not addressing the root cause. In a future video, I will do something to dig a little bit deeper into the weeds and explain things you can do to benefit your gut bacteria. But in general, I do not recommend probiotics to people because they're not addressing the root cause. So hopefully this was helpful. You guys let me know in the comments if you've experienced any of these side effects, what you did about it, if there's anything else you did to help. I like hearing from you, but I know people that watch this video really value other people's feedback. So please do that. And also make sure if you want to learn more about how to eat to support your gut health, make sure to go to my website, get your free checklist. Talk a lot more about this stuff on my email list. So go grab that. See you in the next one, guys. Thank you.